said this to the other coach. I said, we this close, but it's a lot of people that was this close to being a millionaire with a lottery ticket. And it never changed their life. Because we are a family, and you welcome people. You don't ostracize them. And as a team, you lose as a team. It's called a fight. Guess what? We got a black eye. You dead? You dead?
No.
Y'all ready to fight?
Yes.
These friendships last for 30 and 40 years. Family on three. Two, three.
Family!
After years of uncertainty at the top of the program, the Cheltenham men's basketball team has found the man for the job. John Timms is entering his second year as the head coach of the Panthers, and after finishing one spot out of the playoffs last year, Coach Timms is coming in with new goals on his mind.
Our goals were to establish ourselves in the Suburban One, to let our opponents know that we're here to stay, and to make the playoffs.
Walk in on the first day of tryout and see 81 kids. 81 kids. We can fill two football teams right now.
The tension in the gym is palpable as 81 guys are fighting for only 45 spots on the varsity, JV, and freshman teams. As the coaches look on, it is evident that this year's tryouts are bringing out unmatched emotion in the players.
Tomorrow at 3, there'll be a list. I hate doing it this way, but this is the most efficient way of doing it. With names of the teams. Hey, and I mean this from the bottom of my heart. I love you, Kyle.
You too, boo.
I like that, yeah. All right, hard work on 3, 2, 3.
As the 8th period bell rings, 81 anxiety-filled young men rush to the gym with high hopes that they will be able to wear a Cheltenham uniform for the upcoming season.
It feels nice, man. It's been a lot of hard work, you know. We've been working hard.
I'm a little disappointed I didn't make the varsity, but I'm gonna keep working.
People did good. I mean, they made it. They got it, you mean?
If you have an issue with your room or the team that you're on, I can forever change it. So if I say you're swinging and you say, Coach, I don't want to swing, then basically you're telling me you don't want to play. Is that understood?
Yes, Coach.
So all of you guys up here, the first one of you that pout about swinging, I'm just going to cut you.
Coming off tryouts, it is right to work for Cheltenham, with the Panther tip-off tournament only 3 days away. With only 2 days left until opening night, the Panthers got their two key players back from the football team.
It feels good to be back out here with my team, you know what I'm saying? Got big chances this year.
They bring a different toughness to the team. Brandon brings about an intensity, and you can't replace his length.
See that? Back button football. We got potential.
It's a challenge. I'm tired. My legs hurting everything, but I'm happy.
And I love the energy. I love Mac. You are such a welcome addition because his competitive spirit is what we need. We don't want people on a second team accepting that role. We don't want people on JV accepting that role. When you're desperate, you're bound to do anything. And y'all know I always say the one player from last year, the reason why I like him, he go all out here, run through a brick wall. Well, that's what Khalil doing for us right now in the varsity.
From my first day here, Khalil White has been the player who I could say, I could look at and say, they want to say, Coach, I want this to be my program.
He's running through brick walls for us. Some of y'all varsity guys got to get y'all competitiveness up to his right now. And some of y'all young guys, look at him, let him lead you in these practices, because he's showing you what a varsity player looks like. All right, great job. B-Mac came and crashed the board. I can't stop thinking about you enough right now. You made this practice great. I'm getting chills up my back thinking about how you're going to crash these boards because people don't know nothing about you. They just think you like to throw 40-yard interceptions.
He thought I was going to give you something.
I'm not going to give you everything, Mac. I can't give you everything. All right, that was my one joke. Let's go. Hard work on three. Two, three.
Hard work.
With only one day until the tip-off tournament, Cheltenham faces their first real adversity of the season.
The Pinkies getting there, 6 weeks to normal, but I'm not letting it hold me back from playing tomorrow.
Transfer forward Vaughn Jenkins has a dislocated right pinky.
Well, it's definitely going to affect him. He can't really catch the ball, and it's dislocated, actually, so he's not going to be healthy for 10 weeks, which is basically off season for the most part. So he's at about 80%, so we're just trying to teach him how to adjust and shoot with that pinky, but it's going to have effect, but he's still going to be pretty good.
With Jenkins injured, it is evident that the rest of the guys will have to step up on the boards in tomorrow's opener for Central High School.
Rebounding, that will be the key to tomorrow's game. If we are able to rebound and limit those guys to one shot, I think we'll do pretty well.
The excitement is in the air as it is now 24 hours until tip-off in front of a packed Cheltenham gymnasium.
I didn't know what to expect from the team as far as effort. I knew we were prepared. I just didn't know what type of effort this team would give me.
If we get down 10, are you going to be the player saying, "See, I knew I should be starting over him. He garbage. He got 3 turnovers." Or are you going to be saying, "It's all right, let's go. It's all right, let's go. It's all right, let's go." Because here's what I'm telling you. If you're the person saying, "It's all right, let's go," I'm going to give you a chance to show me what he was supposed to be doing.
I tell you, I love you almost at least once a week.
I tell you that because I mean it. We have to be a family.
This game is about who won it the most, who's going to bring their brains. I don't think Central's going to bring their brains. I know they won it. It starts now. Let's go.
I feel good. I was excited to play in front of everybody, and you know the hype was going up the whole week.
The Cheltenham gym is packed, and after 9 months of waiting, opening night is finally here.
Pretty excited to tip off this season.
Although not 100%, Vaughn Jenkins is suited up and going to play.
Tip-off tournament, I was excited. I just wanted to like get the first game over with and get some buckets.
Let's start it now, because this is what it matters, all right? This is our fourth, this is our game.
Yo, go, yo.
This is our fourth, this is our game. Family on three.
Two, three, family!
In front of the home crowd, Khalil White leads the Panthers with 12 first quarter points. Everything was rolling perfectly for the Panthers until Vaughn Jenkins went up to dunk, but his injury stopped not only the basketball, but Cheltenham's momentum too.
We have to what? Take care of Vaughn. To 5 turnovers, a missed layup, that's not good basketball right now.
Anthony White converts on an and one at the buzzer to put Cheltenham up 3 at the half.
They had how many points in the first quarter?
11.
So how many did they score in the second?
17.
17. Here's what I'm here to tell you. Of those 17 points, watch this. 15 of them came off of turnovers and 5.
The energy turns up in the third quarter, and Vaughn Jenkins is making up for his lackluster first half. The inexperienced Cheltenham team showed its face while turning the ball over to give Central a lead in the fourth. Despite the careless play, Anthony White tries to wheel Cheltenham back into the game with some eye-catching crossovers. But the lead is too much to overcome, and Central beats the Panthers 66-59 on opening night.
Now, how do we move forward from here? Here's what I'm going to tell you.
See, I already projected forward because I've been studying the schedule already. We do not want to go to Central Buck West 0-2.
The slow start continues into Saturday's game against Newark. Although Khalil White led all scorers for the second straight night, turnovers once again came back to haunt the Panthers and drop them to a 0-2 on the young season.
8 quarters, I guarantee you, we won 6 of those 8 quarters. And we're 0-2. Pick your heads up, don't walk with your head down. That's not going to get us right. Only thing going to get us right is working hard in practice.
After the poor start, Coach Timms knows his next game will not be any easier. Cheltenham is traveling to play arguably the best shooting team in Suburban 1, Central Bucks West.
If this is good, you're right here. You just gotta prove it to people. I believe it. You believe?
Yes, Coach. Coach.
You believe?
Yes, Coach.
Let's get some W's tomorrow. Let's get some W's. Hey, everybody. Varsity, shirt and tie, come fly.
Shirt and tie.
And JV.
What about JV?
Yeah, oh yeah, everybody.
Questions?
I got one more question, by the way.
Save it. Hey. Hard work on 3, 2, 3.
Last season, the Panthers lost due to CB West's 3-point shooting. So this year, Coach Timms is coming in with a different plan.
This year, I knew that we had to play great defensively and communicate.
If you're not talking on defense, I'm subbing you. If you're not talking, I'm looking at you. If you're not talking on defense, coaches, remind me, I'm subbing you. Right now, we can turn our season around because it starts now. Winning at home is what you're expected to do. Winning on the road builds character. Let's build some character. Let's go.
With Vaughn Jenkins out for 4 weeks, Cheltenham comes into an extremely tough environment against CB West. Despite the tough crowd, the Panthers handled their business, shooting the ball well while holding CB West to just 12 points in the first half.
If they come out, hit a three, don't get down. That crowd gonna get loud.
In the second half, somehow communication got distorted. And whenever you're not communicating against shooters, they wanna shoot you out the gym.
I told you they're going to make some shots, but can they continuously make those shots? I don't believe it.
CB West continued their hot shooting and converted on an unprecedented 11 three-pointers in the second half. After Khalil White answered with a pair of threes of his own, the Panthers had the ball down 1 with 40 seconds left, but they could not convert. With CB West hitting their free throws, Cheltenham had one last chance, but a walk on Khalil White would put an end to this incredible game.
It was one of the best high school games I witnessed, so to be a part of it was good for me. You know, I was on the losing end, but it was a great game.
Damn, that's why we're losing now. Yes, it is. Everybody worried about themselves. That's why we're losing.
I'm not worried about myself.
I feel like we wasn't gelling together. I feel like everybody was trying to do their own separate thing.
So we still got a long season ahead of us. These games are over and behind us. Do not think about these games once we get on that bus and move. You think about your mistakes and how you can get better.
We're going to get back. We're going to get back. I feel it. But everybody was like, nah, y'all going to lose. I'm like, we're going to get back. Trust me.
Looking at our schedule, we played one of the toughest schedules in the Suburban 1. So I knew that going into the season. I knew that the beginning of our schedule was tough. And so it was just trying to get them to understand the state of course.
Back in the comfortable environment of the Cheltenham Gymnasium, CHS has something to prove. Although they didn't quite prove it in the first half, head JV and assistant varsity coach Pat Fleury let them know it.
But you'll never be open if you don't do something for your teammate. You wanna say what I'm telling you? Play for your teammate. The numbers mean nothing. 10 years from now, you might get 30 points. You might get 30. You're not gonna remember the 30 points. You're gonna remember each other. He was a good teammate. He was an alright teammate. He was a selfish teammate. Y'all gotta play for each other. Y'all look dead. 28 points against them.
Coach Fleury's words hit the team in the heart, and they come out of the locker room looking for vengeance.
When you rely on defense as your meal ticket, basketball becomes
real fun because you get steals, you get turnovers. Now you in transition. You get big bomb three-pointers. You get layups, you get dunks. All that comes from behind good defense.
The Panthers' defense leads them to their first win of the year.
Tomorrow, let's make non-believers believers in Cheltenham. Let's go. Let's go. Hard work. Family on three. Family on three. Two, three. Family!
One of the most important parts of the Cheltenham basketball program is assistant varsity and head junior varsity coach Patrick Fleury.
Off the court, like, he just, like, really, like, that big brother, like I need. Like, always there for me and stuff. Anything I need, he got me. Like,
he kind of showed me the ropes. Coach Pat, he's a great coach, great person.
You know, he just got all the energy. You know, that's the energy man. You know, he come out and he lace him up and play with his guy on the floor. You know, talk trash to it.
Fleury has been a member of the Panthers family for over 10 years. He was a star point guard during Cheltenham basketball's most historic years in the early 2000s.
Fleury, guarded by Short, spin. Nice pass to Christopher as he's able to throw a wide open lane.
That was a great shot catch in the corner.
Fleury off the dribble, James a three-pointer as Fleury has brought his best game here tonight.
It was imperative that I kept someone on the staff that has ties to Cheltenham. You know, for me, I want these guys to be able to see someone who wore the same uniform.
Coach Fleury, along with Cheltenham legends Harris and Patrick Mansell, achieved multiple state playoff appearances, district number one seeds, and several conference championships.
It was an amazing time for the school and just all those people that were involved in that helped.
In the gym that you're practicing, when you look up on that wall, you can see your assistant coach. So if that doesn't inspire you, you know, what will?
Fleury has always had a knack for helping others, as he is the all-time leading assist leader at Cheltenham. And this trait drives him each and every day as a coach.
He's a good leader. He knows how to bring people together. He knows how to make you feel comfortable, but also respect them. Because I think that's a strong thing of someone, like an authority figure.
Been the same guy. When he played, he always played with a lot of fire, always had a lot of heart, and I can see it, him on the sidelines now with the same fire and the same passion.
I appreciate him a lot. If it wasn't for him, I don't really think I played this year. So
I think Abington was the best team in the area. Do I feel as though we're on Abington level? Not quite yet, but do I think we can compete and beat them? Yes.
Coming off of last night's win, Cheltenham is facing the defending state Final Four team and next door rival, Abington. Although the Panthers' offense is clicking, All-State selection shooting guard Amir Hinton is giving the Cheltenham defense all they can handle in the first half.
We talk about this. Good players put themselves in position to take over games when it's a good game, when it's a tight game. This is a tight game. This is a good game. This is a tight game. You see him? He said, I'm gonna get 30 if I needed to win. I'm gonna try to dunk on the whole team if I had to. I'm gonna strip everybody that come in front of me. I'm gonna block every shot that come my way. That's what he's doing. So this is still our game. If you take back your mistakes, you can't do it. But what I'm saying is if you don't make them this half, we make that 10 points up and it comes down to a two possession game. I promise you I know what I know, what I know, what I know. If you take care of the damn ball, this game is gonna come down to two possessions.
Cheltenham comes out of the locker room looking to score. And going into the third quarter, they minimize their turnovers. And it is now anyone's game.
Just a crowd, I love the crowd. And that's our rival school, so like, just going back and forth with them, I wanted to bring the W back to Cheltenham.
The crowd is loud, and juniors Khalil White and Maurice Valentine respond to the energy.
Oh,
After the Valentine three, it is a one-possession game, and the crowd is getting loud to help support the Cheltenham defense. Now, down only one, the Panthers foul Abington senior and Westchester commit Matt Penicow. He misses both, but Abington gets the rebound, and he converts two on his second chance to put Abington up three. After Abington strategically fouls Fatir Alahadman up three, the Panthers are left in the dust, and despite their valiant effort, they drop the neighborhood battle to Abington.
There's something to be said about a 1-4 team that had a chance to win every game against undefeated teams. We're getting better. Much, much, much better. Because after the game, I find myself talking to people, because we're family, I always defend you. And I say things like, they come up to me like, tough loss, coach. This was a great game, man. You guys are 1-4, though. How it feel? How's it going? We played three teams that's undefeated. Now we seen what they label good. They said Abington should run away with it. They beat Pensbury. Well, if they f***ing good, what are we? We're three turnovers away from being good. Three turnovers. We're slow down, think away from being good.
With frustration looming around the program, it is right back to practice to try and right the Panthers' wrongs. Coach Tim's frustration is noticeable as he tries to gear his team toward tomorrow's huge league game against Upper Dublin.
Full suicide! 30 seconds, coach, and you better all make it! I'm getting tired of saying the same things over and over again.
When we go out there, you don't even know where you're going. How can we solve that? Say it again, Reese. It's the reason why he started. He's the only one that's getting it right now. He's answering every damn question. And it's starting to piss me off. Because it says y'all don't really get it still. And we less than a half an hour away from a first real league game.
The 6'4 D1 prospect, Simeon Fryer, comes in, leading the Cardinals, and they come out and expose all of the Panthers' defensive weaknesses en route to a double-digit lead heading into halftime.
I said this today, I'm a coach. I said, we this close, but there's a lot of people that was this close to being a millionaire with a lottery ticket. And it never changed their life. But right now, that's where we at. We have five numbers. Now, we either going to cash in a ticket and say, hey, at least give us $500,000, or we going to be that team that says, they was close, but they never could win. The first makeup of a team where you can tell they unified and together is on the defensive side, because they talking to each other. They helping each other. Y'all ain't doing none of that. Y'all sitting around not talking to each other. Don't know who you got. Subbing in for each other. Not telling somebody who you have. That's basketball 101. If we come out and play defense, we still beat this game by 5 to 10 points. But if we don't, welcome to your first blowout. And out of the five opponents we played, other than Upper Marion, this is the weakest. And they're gonna blow your ass out unless you start talking on defense. Now get out of here. Go, go.
Cheltenham's struggles continue in the second half, and Coach Tim said it best. Welcome to your first blowout.
Obviously, it's frustration. No one likes to be blown out. There's no justification for being blown out. If you consider yourself a good team, being blown out is something that just doesn't happen.
I think that was the first time in my coaching career I was stunned.
So if you're not gonna buy in, if I kick trash cans, punch a wall,
then it's great to skin off my knuckles. And that don't motivate you to want to go play defense, then it ain't here. We can't motivate you. It have to be something within you. Hear the guy. This was the worst game I had in Cheltenham uniform as a head coach.
I knew Upper Dublin was good. I respect Upper Dublin to the fullest. I knew they were good. I just didn't think they could beat us from beginning to end.
I expected so much more from you guys today, man. I expected so much more for y'all coming into this, understanding this is a league game and knowing how important this game was. And y'all came in here and let people punch y'all outside y'all head and didn't want to fight. Let's get on the bus, man.
I was so upset. Like, I was pissed. I was throwing things around. I didn't know how to take it because that was our first blowout.
After an easy home win against Springfield, Cheltenham travels to their next real league test against Norristown in hopes of turning their season around. More careless play drives Timms close to his tipping point in the Norristown gym.
Are you to take the ball out? So don't go underneath. That's a simple instruction. Don't take the ball and get up the floor.
A good start to the game becomes seemingly forgotten as the Panthers start to falter on both sides of the court, leading to an 8-point Norristown lead going into halftime.
Amir.
Coming into the season, Fatir Al-Ahad was supposed to be the Panthers' go-to leader and scorer, but up until this point in the season, he has been a disappointment, leading Coach Timms to make one of the most impactful moves of his Cheltenham coaching career.
I'm going to start you this half, but I don't want you playing the ball.
Fatir needed a fire lit under him.
I think it did wake him up.
I just wanted to come back to practice and, you know, just prove to myself how good I was, and I knew how good I was, and just everything, all the hard work, and go out there and practice and show Timms and all my teammates that I was that guy.
I think that was a great move by Coach Timms, and I think Fatir, instead of sulking, he responded positively to it. So
he's like a snake, you know, like lying dormant, but such a deadly killer when he's awakened. You know, so when Fatir is rolling, he's like the best player out there. But he can lie dormant. He can slither right by you and not even bother you.
In the long run, Coach Timms calling out Fatir could prove to move mountains for the Panthers. But for now, Cheltenham is getting blown out once again. Frustration and tension among the team is at an all-time high.
I was hurt because, like, I knew we could have played better than what we did. And I know we could have got a W. So for us to lose and lose by a lot, it was just like a wake-up call that we had to get our stuff together.
I feel like that game made them come together and understand that we have to fight together to give ourselves a chance, or we're going to get blown out.
After an out-of-league victory versus Academy of the New Church, Cheltenham is sitting at 3-6 with their backs against the wall, and with Vaughn Jenkins returning, the Panthers face the biggest game to this point of their season versus Glenn Mills.
I'm going to stick to what I believe in. I know it to work. I know it to work. So what I've said today is if we come out and play defense today, we win.
Big guy. He's going to beat us. So what? He's going to get his 18. He's not going to get 25. He won't get 25. He'll get his 18. We stop everyone else and we win.
Being on varsity since freshman year has prepared Justin Sutton for any matchup that comes his way.
Playing against bigger players actually motivates me more. You know, I get tired of playing teams that the tallest guy is 5'8", and, you know, he's guarding me and I'm 6'3".
We was on pace to have 2 10-point quarters. And then in the last 2 minutes, we decide we're not going to rebound on foul shots, we're not going to box out, and we're not going to contest shots. And they scored 9 points.
A revamped Fatir Al-Ahad is starting to show the type of player he can be while leading the Panthers to a 1-point lead going into the fourth quarter.
If we get back into the paint and make them play hard, half-court offense, we win this game going.
or what? Let's go.
Coming out of the break, Vaughn Jenkins is trying to make up for lost time. But in the process, he turns the ball over and Coach Tim is not happy with the senior transfer. These turnovers haunt the Panthers as it looks like they will go down similarly to their previous games. But after an Anthony White three-pointer, the Panthers' star point guard, Fatir Alahad, sets the tone for the rest of the season, bringing Cheltenham back into the game with his playmaking ability en route to 19 points and a huge 66-59 victory against the Bulls of Glen Mills.
This is a big one. We needed it. We got it. We got it. Now, let's build on it.
Hey, enjoy your victory, but don't enjoy it too much. We'll be right back at it on Monday. Hard work on three, two, three.
Hard work.
Although only 6'4", junior center Justin Sutton makes up his lack of height with post moves that are simply unheard of at the high school level.
What post moves? No, I'm kidding. No, I actually, I go on the internet and I look up old players from different eras and I just watch what they do and I go outside of my court and do it every day.
30-pound lighter Charles Barkley. You know, he's just undersized, but he has a big man game.
Sutton is a perfectionist on the court, and this leads to him being an extremely emotional player.
That's the biggest hindrance to his game.
And they haven't gotten into my head, but in the past it's happened.
I would love to say he's getting better at it, but I just seen him this weekend, and he exploded.
Although this emotional side hurts Sutton at times, it also leads him to be a fearless player on the defensive side of the ball.
The fact that I can impact the game outside of scoring, you know, that really means a lot.
On the Division III level, Justin could be a very effective player in the post.
The junior big man brings eye-catching post moves, and he is the anchor of the Panthers' defense. With undefeated conference rival Plymouth White Marsh coming into the gym on Friday night, the Panthers have to make sure to keep focused in a conference game versus Upper Moreland. To Coach Tim's liking, Panthers seniors Fatir Alahad and Vaughn Jenkins lead the way with 22 and 21 point performances respectively.
I just did some interview. They say you guys are 3-2 in the league. Where do you think you are as a team? I was getting ready to play the political game. But then I said, I'm gonna be honest. I said, we're mediocre on the rise. It's a team game, but today is really about mano a mano. You gotta outplay Mitchell. You have to. He's a senior, you're a senior, we're both in Suburban One. He's getting all the press about being the best point guard in Suburban One. You gotta take that personally. You have to outplay him.
You know, that's motivation, you know, when somebody put in front of you and you wanna go out there and compete.
I don't like doing this, but I have to do it. Because we have to start to understand what it means to be competitive, compete. So you gotta take it personal. Murr, they talk about him the best shooter like you ain't even around here. Like you don't even exist.
Everybody's like piping him up about how good he is. And I know I'm the same thing as him. He a shooter, I'm a shooter. But I think I got the upper hand on defense, so I was ready for the matchup.
You two guards, they're not even talking about you in Suburban One. How you change that? You change it today. You take it personal. I'm better than you. Take it personal, because we're better than them. They coach literally talking to you like, I got to get them up. I got to get them up. I don't know what they're thinking. They're not understanding what Cheltenham's going to bring. You got to get them up. I told them we went to sleep right.
Perilous fight for the ramparts we watch were so gallantly streaming.
Coming into this matchup, Plymouth White Marsh is an undefeated 11-0, so a Cheltenham win could create shockwaves throughout Suburban One. led by Khalil White's counterpart, Jimmy Murray, it is evident that PW is playing no games, and they are coming into Cheltenham with nothing on their mind other than another conference win to stay undefeated. After a quick start from the Colonials, Cheltenham fights back on the offensive end to notch the score up to 18 after one quarter. Yeah. 6'4 Martin Luther King High School transfer Xavier Malone comes at Cheltenham after the break, giving them a comfortable lead. But Fatir Alahad's strong play brings Cheltenham back within three, going into halftime at 27-24.
We got a game to win. We got a game to win. 2 minutes. Hurry up, listen up real quick. I think the swing control right now for Fatir is going to work. I don't think they can stick it. Although, I don't want you solely thinking you're going to get 30. No. I'm just understanding. You're the focal point because they can't stick you. He was 30 last year, he on pace for 30. He has 13 of their 27 points. That's almost half. Jimmy Murray, whose man is that?
It's mine.
Let's go.
Coming out of the halftime locker rooms, both teams turned up the intensity, going back and forth on both ends of the floor.
No go. White with the rebound. And White with...
After going down 8, however, Khalil White and Fatir Alahad bring Cheltenham back to within 3 going into the fourth quarter.
This is what it's about, what I tell you. Undefeated teams, they're not built for this. If this game is in the same position in 2 minutes, we win.
With the home crowd behind them, the Panthers scored 8 unanswered points to start the fourth quarter, and leading by 4. With 4 minutes left, the Panthers set themselves up for battle heading down the stretch.
And he was baptized inside.
Everything set itself up perfectly because they had to fight. And what allowed us to do to recognize that some games aren't about X's and O's. It's not about execution, it's about will.
Hey, y'all know something I don't know.
The final 3 minutes is set up to draw the attention of everyone around the league. Coming back up the floor, Anthony White hits arguably the biggest shot of his high school career to this point, putting Cheltenham up 5. An aggressive take by Xavier Malone gets him to the foul line, knocking down 2 to put the Colonials within 1 possession with the ball coming back into the hands of the Panthers.
I told him that this was a time, this was where we learned to fight. We learned how to fight and we took our gloves off. We were boxing before. Boxing and fighting is different. We were boxing. Boxing, you're protected by gloves. You could put headgear on. You can really protect yourself.
Right back at the PW defense is Fatir Alahad, who hits the Colonials with what seems to be the dagger and an and one, putting the Panthers up 6.
But when it's knuckle on a knuckle, that's like what y'all call it, MMA. There's no gloves, there's no protection. Sometimes basketball games, and you watch the NCAA, they are literally fights. You see people literally fighting.
Experienced senior Jimmy Murray hits a 3 from the corner, and this showed that the fight was nowhere close to being over.
Watch this. Guess what? That was desperation. They was ready to quit. If he missed that shot, that was their game. That was a desperation shot. You gotta understand, right now, they're uncomfortable. They said, we need a 3. Yeah, it's 2 minutes left, and they said, we need a 3.
Again, it is Fatir Alahad, right back at PW with an eye-catching pull-up jumper to put the Panthers back up 5. And a Murray air ball gives the ball back to the Panthers with the game in their hands.
We were up about 5 points with the ball with 2 minutes left.
An extremely rare turnover from Fatir Al-Ahad allows Xavier Malone to glide in for an easy layup, putting the Colonials guess within what? Three once again.
Remember when I say take it personal? Now, say take the ball from me. That's my taking it personal. Strong with the ball. That's what they got to do. They got to run a track. Be strong with the ball. Step through.
Up three, another turnover haunts the Panthers as Khalil White turns it over, giving the ball back to BW with the clock winding down. Although it bounces out, BW gets the tip, bringing them within 1 point with 7 seconds left. With the weight of the world on his shoulders, Anthony White gets fouled.
I was just competing, like, I knew I was going to make him, like, I wasn't just on confident, but, because I know Jimmy, like, he could hit it, like, so I was like, I got to make sure we go, I got to make two, because if we only go up one, that's when we up two, and he make a three, that's when we crease, so I know I had to make both of them, and then when I did, I just felt confident, I just knew we had one more stop.
After converting on the first shot, Anthony White knocks down the huge second opportunity, and the Panthers are up three with 7 seconds left. What would be the most historic win in Coach Tim's career was up in the air.
The fans rush, the fans upset the 11-0 Colonial Plymouth White Barns.
They were quote unquote the best. All the newspapers talk about them. They're this, they're that, they're so great, they're number one. So it's like, you beat the best team, you know, you just feel like you're a little better at the moment.
If you even see my reaction after the game, it was pretty much like...
We ain't gonna go home and open no Christmas presents. We better than them. We came in with a game plan. If we execute our game plan, this will be the end result every time. Let's win 80% of our last 10 games left, and let's make the difference.
I feel as though we're doing what we're supposed to now. We're back on check. I always knew we was the best team in the area, one of the best teams in the area. We just had to prove it.
It's a big one. PW was undefeated and number one in the league. So for us to defeat them, that's a great and big win.
I feel good. I think we're on a winning streak. I think we're going to keep going. And I think we're good.
Cheltenham showed his personality against PW, and spirits were high amongst the guys, especially some of the guys who would be considered the so-called clowns of the team.
Clown. It's a lot of clowns on this team. You know, you got Jamil, you know, he just booby, you know, he crazy. You got Lil, you know, Lil do his little stuff.
Lil always doing something.
Here's what I say.
We keep peeking. We get to the top of the block and we looking around that corner. We keep looking around it. Let's walk around it today. Let's turn that corner today, all right?
Fresh off the biggest win of the year, Cheltenham faces Wissahickon, and Coach Timms knows this is a tougher task than the guys think.
We thought we just going to show up and beat Wissahickon. I think that's part of the area that I have to change the culture. So Wissahickon right now would be my rival.
In this back and forth matchup, it is big man Justin Sutton that is getting the best of the smaller Wissahickon team. But this does not seem to be enough to beat the Trojans' balanced attack.
So for me, it's not discrediting Wissahickon. I think Wissahickon coming in with a great system, they well coach. I just think it's part of the culture in the area that our kids know those kids. And just automatically say, I'm better than you. I'm better than you. And don't show, improve it. It needed to be said, and it didn't. I'm glad it didn't come from me.
You're not gonna win a game or win multiple games or be a good team if you're not a team.
So when they said that, I was like, great. Because I love for my assistant coaches to step up. Challenge them. Say something. Say what you feel. Because guess who's going to support you? Me.
Close the front door. Because we get ready to get the monkey out. Get ready to get the monkey off the back.
It didn't have to come from me. Great. I'm glad it didn't come from me. Yes. And so when he said it, he's right. And then it allowed me to point.
It showed its face in winning, and I thought that it'd take care of itself, but it showed its face again. Right now, we got a bunch of haters on our team. That's what it sounds like. Yeah, Vaughn, I took you out because I was upset with you, not because of what's going on, but I get so sick and tired of hearing y'all correct his mistakes from the bench. I get so sick and tired of hearing y'all announce his mistakes from the bench. Yeah, okay, some of y'all might be upset that he came in and he's playing a little more than y'all. And he's new to the school and you feel like you're supposed to be playing more minutes than him. But now you're starting to break the team up when he make a mistake and you sitting up there like, see, he should be sub. I'll do that. When I'm in the game, that don't happen. See, he don't come out.
It called them all out in front of each other and made them self-check.
It's corny. Because part of the reason why he's playing horrible, and I'm using that word, is because we're putting him on the out. And I'm not belling him out. I'm not giving him an excuse. Put yourself in that position. Go to a new school. Go to a new environment. I've been there before. It's not a welcoming sight. People don't open up their doors for you. And then come on the team and had the talent that he had. People ain't gonna be looking at you like, ooh, and then let him play and not produce. Then y'all can really point the finger like, see, they talking about like he really good, like we gonna be winning, he's gonna come and score us 30 or something. It's like people can wait to do it. So don't make it seem like I'm sticking up for his play. But if it was my son right now, I would feel some kind of way. Because we are a family, and you welcome people. You don't ostracize them. That's why we couldn't win today.
It made some people uncomfortable, which was the goal.
And as a team, you lose as a team. It's called a fight. Guess what? We got a black eye. You did?
No.
Y'all ready to fight?
Yes.
Y'all ready to fight?
Yes.
In order to change, you have to go through some sort of discomfort. I think once they went through the discomfort, they started to realize that success only would happen if they all bought in.
Let's go. Don't point fingers, fellas. Don't point fingers. Family on three. Two, three.
Family.
I think it's like brothers together. Like, whether you like it somebody or not, you just gotta come together because it's a team. At the end of the day, we got one goal.
With the Wissahickon loss, Cheltenham comes into Upper Marion with their backs against the wall. And like every other time, when the fate of the season is hanging in the depths, it is Fatir Al-Ahad who leads the Panthers.
When Fatir is going offensively, we will not lose. But we'll learn to blow people out when Fatir is going offensively when we start to play defense. They do not share the ball. This is what they said about Shaw. They really think they're good. No, they're not. They lost to Central Buck West. They got blown out by Norristown. They lost by 30 to Upper Dublin. This is what he's going to say. You know their record? They are 10-4. So when you playing a 7-7 team, his job is to coach them up. To make them look at your record. Watch where I'm going. And he want to use your record as a platform to say they're better.
Coming into the game at 7-7, this is Cheltenham's first chance to break 500 all year. But the 10-4 Council Rock North team is rolling through their season with only one loss at home all year long.
We needed to play defense and come with intensity since we weren't in our environment.
Right from the jump, the Panthers use their superior athleticism to their benefit, as Khalil White leads the Cheltenham defense with four of his season-high 7 steals in the first half.
They made 5 field goals the whole first quarter, first half, 5. They made 3 threes and 2 twos. They're going to make a couple more shots.
Coach Timms knows that Council Rock North can shoot, and this proves true in the second half as the Indians drill threes a la CB West. The Panthers find themselves down 9 with 1 minute left on their way to what looks like a devastating loss. After a Brandon Mack putback cuts the lead to 7, Fatir Alahad hits a huge and one to make it a 2-possession game. Cheltenham forces a turnover, and then Khalil White gets fouled shooting a 3, going to the line down 4 with a chance to make the game a little more interesting. After White makes 2 of the 3, the Panthers fouled down 2. Council Rock North converts on 1, and with 7 seconds left, Cheltenham has one chance to do the impossible and complete the comeback to save their playoff hopes.
So what is Khalil going to do? Exactly what I tell him to do. Run off that screen. Lil, we don't have seconds. We don't have time. We don't have time. Soon when you catch it, you have to let it go.
Hey, give me the ball. Like, in my head, I was like, I want it. I know I'm going to knock it down. Cause like, and then like the coaches is looking at me, so like I just knew like it was my time.
I was like, damn, Khalil just really hit a buzzer beater.
The key to that play was Justin Sutton. If Justin don't set that screen, Khalil don't get open. So every bit of that huddle wasn't about Khalil. The huddle was about Justin.
With their emotions flying high, the Panthers would not look back, outscoring Council Rock North 14-5 in overtime, leading to a win that not only brought the team together, but brought about a newfound belief in Coach John Timms.
Their belief in me changed at Council Rock North. I felt like I looked in the eyes and they felt like Coach can get us through anything.
I didn't know we were going to come back like that, honestly. Khalil always hit shots like that.
I was really excited.
This is how you bounce back after this evening. You come in Council Rock North, I guarantee you this. Without looking, they probably lost one game here all year. Great, 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 great win. I never had such a situation in my life.
Hey, I love y'all. Family on 3. 2, 3, family!
Coming into Martin Luther King High School on MLK Day, Cheltenham has an incredible experience to acclimate themselves into Philly basketball history. MLK is the defending City of Philadelphia champions, and with several Division I players returning, Cheltenham has their toughest test in the past 5 years of the program.
It's a handful that think you can win, but it's a smaller hand that know you can win. You gotta know you can win tonight. It ain't about thinking, it's about kicking back, making them guard you, and playing team ball.
After fighting well for a while, the experience and home court advantage powers MLK to the decisive victory. Coming back home to a must-win game versus Upper Dublin, Fatir Alahad leads the Panthers in style with 14 points, 8 rebounds, 6 assists, and 6 steals. This is fitting considering the word around Suburban 1 is that Coach Timms is the most fashionable coach in the league.
Wears nice clothes. He does.
You agree with that?
Yeah, he actually wears really nice outfits, I have to admit.
You know, he like to come out and, you know, smile and, you know, walk around the whole gym showing his nice little suit, but
everything sharp, like everything new. And like, yeah, I don't know what cologne you use, but he smells good every game.
He tries to do too much sometimes with his clothing, but I think he is the most fashionable coach.
I'd be tight at times, like a little too small, but like.
That's a lie. All the coaches, you know what I'm saying? Coach Sims, if you watch this, all the coaches have better swag than you.
I have four sisters, and they're fashion critics. And so when I don't come out the house looking right, I'm going to get it.
Fresh off a big win, it is Anthony White that prevents even the mere thought of a letdown game.
I got to make sure that I cook things for what I got to.
When he let the game come to him, y'all see it. Anthony White can look like a Division I player at times. His pull-up jump shot, he come off and he in rhythm and he in motion and his confidence is high. He's that type player.
Because we beat Norristown twice, we forgot that Norristown and PW are the teams to beat in Suburban One.
Although Cheltenham beat Norristown twice last year, the Eagles were coming in with vengeance, looking for a chance to sweep the Panthers and kill their playoff chances.
Nobody frown. Nobody frown, all right? This our game. They got 20 points. Everything is right where we want it.
A Khalil White three opens up the half, and alongside great defense, the Panthers take the lead going into the fourth quarter.
You're the best defensive team in this conference. Now, you're at home in the fourth quarter with a four-point lead.
Coach Tim's words get to the Panthers as their outstanding defense put them in great offensive opportunities to put the game out of reach.
You are the best defensive team in this conference. The only other team that mirrors you defensively is who? Is who? How do you show them who's the best defensive team? Beating them a what?
Again.
Who you thinking about tomorrow? Who you thinking about tomorrow? Who you thinking about tomorrow? I told everyone in Suburban One, I think we got the best guards in the conference. I said it might be written, because I know they love the quote when I say stuff like that. They can't wait to put them quotes up. I said, PW, look at the book. And this is what we're going to leave on. I said, look at the scores when we play PW. They said, what about PW? Fateh Al-Ahad gave them 20. Khalil White gave them 11. Anthony White gave them 13. You ready for them? Malone, 15. Mitchell, 10. Murray, 16. You tell me who to help.
They believe we were a fluke.
Try and cap the number one guard, Fateh Al-Ahad.
On Plymouth White Marsh's senior night, the Colonials are looking for revenge. They have a packed house to cheer them on. PW comes out on fire, and it feels like the Panthers are in for a long night. Until Brandon Mack single-handedly brings life to the Cheltenham players and fans.
Brandon Mack gives us the most energy on the team.
Cause like they got into my head a little bit. They kept saying my name, but when the coach was talking to me, he was like, settle down. That's when things got better.
The energy from Brandon Mack lights a fire under his teammates, and the three guards, Al-Ahad, White, and White, pave the way as Cheltenham climbs back into the game.
Let's take care of the ball. Let's come back and turn the tide. Watch this. First five minutes, there's only 3 minutes left when we go down. First 5 minutes of this game is going to make the difference in this third quarter.
Quality possession.
You come out here, get quality possession, get quality shots.
Come on.
Watch the game.
Come on.
PW comes out of the locker room looking to score, and early in the second half, they broke the game open. Despite late efforts by Fatir Al-Ahad, the game is just a step out of reach for Cheltenham, and PW splits the regular season series.
Everybody walk with y'all head up. Because guess what? They happy they beat y'all. They happy. Because they know the better team right here is in this room. All right, let's go one time. We'll see them again. We'll see them again. Family on three. Two, three, family!
After the tough loss to PW, it is right back to work for Cheltenham, coming into the gym for senior night, and the final game of the season was none other than Wissahickon.
Once you get to that confident level where you say, ah, I got this, you better really have it. You better really have it. Because if you don't, you're going to get a slice of humble pie. And Wissahickon always gave us our humble pie.
But this night is real special. I promise you it's real special. Because for me, at 42 years old, I still remember the butterflies of senior night.
You know, I had to, you know, get my fresh haircut. I was whooping all season.
I got to start, so I didn't really think I was going to start a high school varsity game.
I wanted to score like 40.
You know, I was just happy to play in front of the fans and my family and friends.
And here's Cheryl Seagans inside.
The Cheltenham seniors come out with a strong start, spearheaded by Jason Searles and Fatir Al-Ahad. But Wissahickon's methodical attack gives the Trojans a 10-point lead going into halftime.
Bang!
It's everybody! It takes everybody to win in the playoffs! And I thought we understood that! We gotta go out in the second half and play defense like we know how!
Coming out of halftime, it is evident that the Panthers leader, Fatir Al-Ahad, is going to change the pace of the game.
Sometimes you just got to get out of people's way as a coach. And Fatir is one of those players where who can do anything they want on the floor.
He rolls over and rebound there. He drives, step back jumper, bang!
Al-Ahad's dominance and strong defense drives the Panthers to within 4 going into the fourth quarter.
Now we're playing defense like we're supposed to play defense. It's about defense. It's about defense. We do the same thing this quarter. We win.
And that's blocked.
Strong defense from Vaughn Jenkins and Justin Sutton leads the Panthers in the fourth quarter. And after an Anthony White and one, the Panthers find themselves tied up with 3 minutes left. On his senior night, Fatir Al-Ahad was virtually unstoppable in the second half. Tied at 42 with 1 minute left, the refs achieved what no Wissahickon player could. Al-Ahad fouls out of the game. After making one of two, Wissahickon is up 1 with 30 left. But Al-Ahad's absence leaves a huge hole in the Panthers' offense.
Somebody's gonna get in the middle, turn and face the basket. We gotta make a basketball play now. You guys are playing not to lose instead of to win. You gotta stay aggressive. Look to attack the basket if you got a lane.
Anthony White gets fouled while down 1. He's at the line shooting 2 with 5 seconds left.
And like on the layup, I swear I was going to get the end one. I swear it was going in. And when it did, I was like, damn. So I don't know. I'm thinking it's all right. I'm going along confident. And I shoot the first one. It felt good coming off my hand, everything. And then it just went in and out, came out. And it hurt me. Like, I was like, dang, I needed that one. Come to the line a second time. And my head was still on the first one.
Anthony White misses both free throws, despite being one of the team's best free throw shooters. After Wissahickon makes both at the line, the Panthers have 4 seconds left to try and create some last-second magic.
This guy pop out, this guy flash, right? Look, I want you all the way down here. When you flash Vaughn, this is Vaughn. Vaughn, you flash, and this is you popping out. Matt, see if you can get it on the pop out.
I cried everything in the LP.
Now we just gotta pray and hope we get in. Now we gotta pray and hope we get in. Let's get it in. Let's get it in. Family on three, two, three.
Family.
We're five.
Despite the heartbreaker on senior night, Cheltenham has done what at one point was thought of as impossible. They have earned the 29th seed in the district playoffs and will be facing...
That I absolutely hate PW.
Former Cheltenham 1,000-point scorer Rob Mansell personifies the PW vs. Cheltenham rivalry perfectly. And having split the season series, the two teams will meet in the first round of the playoffs.
I knew we had beat him already. So I was like, yeah, we good. That's a good game.
I was excited because we beat them once, they beat us once. So I just felt like it was any person's game.
We was excited because, you know, we beat them before and we definitely felt that we could beat them again, you know. We had the game plan.
Cheltenham is only one of two teams on the season to beat PW. And going into Friday night's game, Coach Timms and the Panthers are excited for the challenge of facing them again.
And sometimes they say be careful what you ask for. Well, we want to beat them. We want to.
Along with the end of the season, the all-league selections have been made.
Wow, congratulations. You might not know, they might not post it. First team.
What's going on, sir? It was, can't find the words. It was.
One thing I say, I fall hard for that. You know, like it was a meeting. And it really like, you know, they throw your names in, and it's a committee, and they argue for who should be on first team. We should be on first team. And I basically said, tell me one guard that can stop me. And they looked and they said, you know what? You're right. It was a unanimous selection.
Let's go.
That means something. That means every coach in this conference thought you was top five player in the conference.
I was real excited and happy, you know, that people chose me and said my name. And it was a unanimous vote that I was first team.
Third team was Justin and Khalil.
I'm kind of happy, but I'm just working on next year, your first team.
That says something. When you average 8 points and can be an all-star, that says something.
It's a great accomplishment, actually. It feels good to be recognized individually.
That means people see how you impact the game outside of scoring. All they kept saying is, well, if he ever just took the hook shot, he'd score about 20 points. You know what I said? I can't get any shooting now. I want any shooting. I want him to take the hook shot 10 times a game. Three players on all conference team. Only other team that has three players. PW.
We wanted them in the playoffs. We did.
You could be put in no better position. You played a team that they picked to win the whole district today. The whole thing. How disrespectful. We beat them. It seemed like everybody forgot but us. So tonight, you have a chance to remind everybody that we didn't beat them because they were off. We beat them because we're better than them. It just took us longer to get to where they are. And I was thinking about that camera. And I was thinking about when we were 2-6 and they were coming in here and practice every day. And what it's going to look like on that documentary when we were 2-6. And everybody was counting us up. To now be at the point where at the end of this documentary, you guys are in the district playoffs. Got to have first team all-conference player and two more on the all-conference team. I get chills when I think of how far we came from 2-6 as a team. We got a mission. Our mission is district. And if we beat the best team in the district, then our goal should be to win. Why wait till next year when we can do it now? Y'all ready?
Yes,
coach. Hey, let's go. Family on three. Everybody stick together. We need it tonight, man. Everybody stick together tonight. Family on three. 2-3. Family.
After an intense drive 20 minutes down the Pennsylvania Turnpike, Cheltenham arrives at PW's gym 45 minutes before game time, and there is not an open seat in sight.
They was like, why you don't want nobody like y'all? Got a couple people call me like, tell them I like y'all. I got a friend's man. Like, why you don't want nobody like y'all? I said, because I like the gamble. Not now. When I was young, I like the gamble. Right? Think about a gambler. If I'm a gambler, I don't want none of y'all to like what I'm doing. Because if any of y'all like it, y'all taking away from my earnings. Because I got confidence I'm going to win. So if I got confidence I'm going to win, I want to bet you $1, you $1, you $1, you $1, you $1, you $1, you $1. I don't want none of y'all to say, I like him. Let me bet him $1 for you. Let me bet him $1. I'm with you. I'm with you. No, nobody with me. Everybody against me. So when I win, I collect what? All. You get all the respect, but nobody believes. Nobody right now believes but us. We don't want nobody walking out here saying, oh, I think y'all can win. We don't want them looking at us like, y'all can't win. Y'all can't win. Y'all can't win. And let's go. Hey, we said Suburban won, we ain't get the title, but this is show who the pro champions right. is right now. Right. We're show who won Suburban won right now. Right. This is our conference. Uh-huh. Let's take control of it right now. Family on 3, 2, 3, family! Let's go!
From the jump, PW's playoff experience shows its face, and they jump out to a quick 8-0 lead.
Yeah, you know, I love the moments, you know, when, you know, fans there and the hype is there and, you know, they're saying like big players come out in big time games, you know. So that's the best time to really show off and show your talent. So I pride myself in those.
As he says, Fatir shows up when the crowd is there. And tonight, on the biggest stage of his high school career, he is arguably the best player on the court.
Fatir had an opportunity to prove that he was the best guard here.
If you wake him up, you're in for a long night.
They can't guard you. We need you to set some screens for him. If you set the screen, you got to roll.
Al-Ahad is not only scoring himself, but he is also finding his teammates all over the floor. With Fatir Al-Ahad drawing the focus of the PW defense, the rest of the Panthers start to get looks at the basket, and with 4 minutes left in the half, it is a one-possession game.
Let's put this on record. PW gets home cooking. Big time.
With the lead clear in sight for the Panthers, the referees decide to make their presence known. They significantly change the momentum of the game.
It's our game. It's still our game. You see, we cut it back. Then the referees put them back in the situation. We can't use the referees as excuses. We have to beat them with the referees. That's part of the element. This is
Coming out of halftime, it is very back and forth as seniors for both sides use their experience to lead their teams. Despite the incredible effort by Fatir Al-Ahad, the Panthers just do not have enough firepower to regain the lead.
Fatir had a semi-young team to carry that I think he never quit, which was very big. When we talk about programs, that's one of the things that we instill within our program.
I think Fatir's a spark. I mean, he fought. He wanted it. He gave everything he had. He gave everything he had.
We could have gave them a better game than what we did.
Say this, I'm proud of you. And the reason why, because we talked about it before we came here in the gym. We talked about the documentary. And after our eighth game of this year, we were 2-6. It was a real dark time for the program, for practice, and for everyone. You were able to turn that around into a successful season. Today doesn't determine your success. Does that make sense? Today doesn't determine your success. Are we good?
Let's go.
Hey, one hell of a year. Yeah, we would have liked it to end a little differently. We would have liked to have been in the game, giving ourselves a chance to win. But they're picked to win it for a reason. All right? And it's twice as hard to beat them here.
Practicing with y'all every day, fighting with y'all every game. But it's going to be the last game. I love all y'all.
You too, bro. Hold on.
Show me something next year, please, bro. I love you.
Hey, love you too, man. Family, all three. That's why we do it, y'all. That's why we do it. These friendships last for 30 and 40 years. Some of the guys I played ball with at 8 years old is my best friends. Family, all three. Two, three.
Family!